What's up, guys? In today's video, we got another banger! Now, guys, I finally unlocked Atomic Camo in Call of Duty Vanguard. Now, this camo is actually kind of cool as hell. I'm not even gonna lie, dude. At first, I was skeptical, but, like, now that I've started putting on, like, all the guns and stuff, it's actually not all that bad. It just, it feels good to actually have this thing unlocked because now I can use whatever guns I want and whatever setups I want. In today's gameplay, you're gonna see me unlock the actual camo itself, and then you're actually gonna hear me talking about the whole grind itself and, honestly, the whole future of Call of Duty in general. And I hope you guys do enjoy today's video. If you guys do, make sure you guys do drop a thumbs up to today's video and do comment down below. Also, do subscribe if you're new right here. We're on the road to 16,000 subscribers. All of your love and support is very appreciated. And I hope you guys do have a great day. Much love again, guys. Hope you enjoy the video. I had to mute my team, man. They too upset right now, bro. I'm not trying to hear all that when I unlock Atomic. They ain't vibing with each other right now. And it's okay. They don't have to be. I'm proud of them either way. I won't pay. I won't pay you. No way. I'm gonna get Atomic today. Hey, unlock diamond camo for all weapon classes. Let's see that Atomic pop up, baby. I want to see it! There it goes. Yo, my team getting smacked right now. Can y'all just keep up for a second, please? 5 hours later, is it going through like every SMG do it? Mythical? What's mythical? Atomic, baby! Woo! You know, I think the craziest thing about this whole Atomic grind, it wasn't like the fact that it was like hard as hell. I mean, don't get me wrong, it was hard. If you don't have the time to grind after a camo, much less like let alone like level up your gun, you're gonna see yourself struggling like crazy. Cause you gotta think, man, like getting a gun to level 70 is already difficult as it is because it's time consuming. And especially if like you don't have like any double XP tokens, you haven't fucking played during double XP weekend. You know, it's a lot harder to get it done. And like that's my thing, man. People are always like, oh yo, you have no life. Bro, if I'm being honest with you, any time that I was able to play the game, and when I was off work and stuff, I was doing it, man. My girl even started playing with me more often, bro. And it's like, she enjoys this game too with me. It's like, people hate on this game so much, but this game really isn't bad, dog. To be blunt about it, this game is not bad. It's just, I think that people are just so used to playing like arcade style fucking Call of Duties that it's like, when you get like a Call of Duty, it's like, it doesn't really feel like an arcade style COD. People will hate more, you know? So I feel like next year, during the whole Modern Warfare hype and shit that everything's going on right now, saying, oh my god, the game's had 3 years to develop and stuff, I feel like the people that were fanboys of 2019 are actually gonna like it a lot. But then you're gonna have those traditional arcade shooter Call of Duty fanboys that'll be like, yo, this game's trash. That's just how I see it. There's always a honeymoon phase, bro, because people were dogging this game like a few months after it released, but when it first came out, people were talking about how good the game was. So it's just like, I feel like every Call of Duty every year faces it, and it's just, it's stupid, man. The biggest thing I'd say about this COD, bro, is like, I've been telling all my friends to form their own opinions about it and don't just listen to reviews online or listen to people like big streamers, because being blunt about it, most of the big streamers nowadays, they just want to play f***ing Warzone. And it's like, if you grew up playing multiplayer and you don't want to play Warzone, you shouldn't feel like you're forced to. Just because everybody's telling you it's the best thing. Like, if your friend told you to go jump off a bridge and, like, you know, you were gonna die and you knew you were gonna die, would you do it? I know I'm gonna have some people saying yes in a joking way, but literally fuck off. Because this is coming from somebody who plays this game every day, and now, even though I have Atomic Camo unlocked, I'm still gonna be playing this game every single day. I have no interest in playing Warzone right now. We grew up playing multiplayer, man, and it's like, we're also the same people that are destroying it. Because if not enough people play multiplayer, sorry teammate, we're just gonna start seeing multiplayer go down and down and down and down and down. I mean, it's already on a downward trend, but from what I've been hearing, they're delaying Call of Duty 2023, which means not this year, but next year's COD. And if they do that, I can see them doing like a good thing for the franchise. Just because I feel like the developers themselves need a break, especially Treyarch, man. Treyarch has been literally helping out with every single Call of Duty. But I don't know. I feel like Call of Duty in general in the next few years is going to be completely different than what we're used to, because Microsoft transitioning and owning Activision now, it's going to make a big difference, I feel like, in the years coming. So I hope just to see like some better community involvement. I just hope to see like three lane maps coming back. I want to see leaderboards coming back, lobby leaderboards, stuff like that. Even just, it's just simple things that they've taken out over the years that I wish were back in the game itself. And I feel like skill-based matchmaking needs to be tweaked down too. I want you guys to tell me down in the comments below what you think about this as well. And if you guys have, thought about things that you wish would come back into Call of Duty, I really want to know what you guys have to say as well. But I hope you guys did enjoy the video. Much love again, guys. Peace.